Hey guys, I'm gonna do another video walking on the roof. This time it's pretty nice outside. It's not too sunny. It looks like it's just a little bit of clouds, but it's in the afternoon, so it's like 1:30 in the afternoon. And I'll take you for a little walk here. I'm trying to do every 2 hours now just to get out. Yeah, so anyway, I found out that people just, when they sweep their rooms, they just sweep it out into the hallway. So that I noticed there's a bunch of trash and stuff out in the hallway, and evidently the maintenance, they don't sweep the hallway every day because it's been there for like 2 days. Just a bunch of trash and stuff. And I noticed, I saw two people, they had their doors open and they were just sweeping it out in the hallway instead of just throwing it in the trash. So you have to walk through all the trash and stuff, dirt, which, you know, it's the little things, you know, when you're locked up and you don't get out, you know, little things start to add up. You know, the noises, the neighbor across the way with his loud TV. I can hear it in my room with his door open. And he's coughing and he's hacking, he's sneezing, and the wind just blows right into the hallway. It's just like little things that little things start to irritate you really, really much, really a lot. It's just, you know, just being cooped up. Anyway, I'm gonna show you a little bit. It's beautiful out. Yesterday there was people, we're flying kites. I haven't seen a kite fly in a long time. But anyway, let me show you. My screen, let me go over here. Yeah, the screen was just really dark. Anyway, these guys here, they built a little table and they're it's like these little pucks, and they try to knock them into the corners. I forget what they call that, but yeah, so they've been playing this. They built it yesterday. And so they, I don't know if you can see that. I can't even see my screen. The screen is black. But the construction is still going on over here. A little bit, there's like two or three guys working. And it's always a nice breeze up here. Probably the camera microphone can pick this up. Yeah, they don't sweep this up either. They don't sweep the trash. I don't know what they get paid for, because it's 2,000 pesos per unit that goes to the you know, the fund for their business, the condo fees, which is $40 US per unit. I don't know how many units, probably 1,200 units. But they don't really seem to do any maintenance at all, none. I think this building's built 9 years ago, I think. And this was the temporary housing for the workers that built this condo, and they're still here. I think they just let them stay here and then they build other things. But this was all the scaffolding when they built the condo. But you know, none of the guys here are working. Anyway, moving on over to the end here. This is the place I like. It's really nice out. But this guy here is open. He opened a couple days ago, but no one's around, no one's doing, you know, no one's buying anything, no one has money to buy. There's a business here, I've seen like two guys there, when I'm up here like for a half an hour, I'll see like two guys or something, but just no one's buying anything. Before, this whole street here was packed. I mean, you'd have lines at some of these stores. You'd have lines, but just nothing now. But it's the hot season. The hot season now, so it gets over 90 degrees every day now. Unless it's really a lot of clouds or raining, but I think it's 92 or 93 degrees today. But the water looks really nice. I think over here, that beach over there is, they call Times Beach. And then you have a bunch of little resorts and stuff along the beach. But it didn't really get good reviews. So I don't know how good they are. I haven't been there. I don't think the beach is supposed to be very good right here, but anyway, that's it for today. I wanted to show you during the day. Oh, there's some kites, if you can see them. There's there's four kites right there. I zoomed in, I don't know if you can see those. They're right up there, right? There's the dark one, and then you have a white one, and then two up there. They're pretty high up. They had one kite, it was a glider. It looked like a big glider, it was really cool. Yeah, so curfew is still from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. or 6 p.m. to 6 a.m., sorry. So it gets, there's hardly anybody on the street at 6 p.m., 6:30. You see a few, but I don't know, you know, if they have jobs that require them to be out at night. If they have, if they work in a hospital or work somewhere where they have to be out, what they call an essential business, then they could be out in the street. But these guys over here, they still play basketball over here. Looks like a couple of them have jeepneys that aren't running. You can see the yellow jeepney there, and there's a blue one, two blue ones, and they're not running. So a lot of people just aren't making money. There's, I mean, nothing. And it's been 1 month today. Today is April 15th. It started March 15th. It actually started like March 12th, 13th, around there, kind of, where they were kind of telling everyone this was going to happen. And there was kind of some things going on, but, you know, but on the 15th, midnight on the 15th, I think is when, that's when the lockdown went in, and then, or the enhanced lockdown. And then, a week and a half ago, 2 weeks ago, we got our passes. So we were allowed to go in and out until about 2 weeks ago without even a pass. And then, of course, 2 weeks ago, then they did that. So we have to have a pass when we go out. But everyone has to come back in by 6 p.m. And you can't leave by until 6 a.m. unless, I guess, you go to the hospital or something. But even then, I don't know how you get there because there's no transportation running, no taxis, no nothing. So I don't even know how you even get to the hospital. The hospital's like, I want to say 6 miles away. So, you know, if you're injured or something, you're not going to be able to walk it for sure. But the people that have private cars, you can still drive around. But most, you know, tourists and most Filipinos, they don't have private cars. So anyway, that's it. Sorry about the wind noise, guys. The wind, it's a little breezy up here. It's really nice. It's just enough to cool you off where you don't sweat. I don't know if you can see it. I zoomed out now, but there's like little white caps. So it's pretty windy out there. Go to the other side. Here's somebody's doing their laundry. I tell you, laundry dries really quick here. I bet you maybe an hour, not even an hour, your clothes are dry. I tell you, it would be really nice if you had a scooter, because since there's no traffic, it'd be really nice to drive around in a scooter. Because when it, you know, before there was so much traffic, it's so dangerous just to be on a scooter or bike, or that I wouldn't even want a scooter. But now, since the roads are so nice and there's no traffic, then, man, driving around on a scooter would be awesome. See, there's just no one at the stores. None. None of these stores, no one's there. No one's buying anything. All right, guys, that's gonna do it. Just a little update. I wanted to show you what it's like during the day. And like I said, it's just, I mean, being locked down, it just, everything just starts to irritate you, you know, even just little things that normally wouldn't bother you just really irritate you. And just stuff we have to put up with, you know, until we can get out. And it looks like the lockdown's going to be until, well, it's until April 30th, so 2 more weeks for sure. And then they said they were going to gradually reduce things, which means probably still social distancing and wearing face masks and gloves if you have them. They don't require gloves, but they require face masks. You can't go into the supermarket or anything. Or just walk around without a face mask. You get a fine, you can go to jail. But they'll probably still require something like that. But then let the businesses open up. And then who knows, you know, what's going to happen after that. I'm hoping they let flights up, you know, let the international flights and stuff so people that are stuck here can go back home. But they haven't said anything about that either. It was actually supposed to be the flights, the local flights between the Philippines Islands were supposed to be available starting yesterday, I think, the 14th. But they're not. They're still shut down. All airlines are shut down. All boats. So you can't go between the islands at all. Unless you have your own boat, I guess. I don't know how that works, but there's a few trikes that are still able to work here. I don't know if they're doing it illegally or not, but every once in a while I'll see a trike with a passenger in it. They said that, you know, you could put your family members in it, you know, people that are related to you or that you live with or something. It was okay to be in a trike, but I've seen people just hand the trike guy a bunny and leave, so. Yeah. Anyway, that's going to be it for today, guys. Sorry for the long video, but I'm really bored and I have nothing else to do. All right, we'll talk to you guys later.